Hello, Sweet Cheeks. Yep, you. It's David and Toby here with some news from this week in which Notch spent too much time playing Minecraft and his head went square. The team at Mojang have planned to live stream from Friday the 17th to Sunday the 19th of February. In other words, this weekend. They'll be creating a game from scratch over a period of about 60 hours. And through teaming up with guys at Humble Indie Bundle, it worked on a basis that us viewers and supporters donate, getting the game in its final state post-livestream. Giveaways and question and answer sessions have also been mentioned. The best part is that all of the money from this goes off to charity. Public voting is well underway for what genre and theme of the game it should be. It's exciting for us, and a challenge for the guys as they approach a fresh idea. Links are below for the Twitter accounts that will bring you and us further announcements.
Next up in 10 News... That's right, folks, LEGO Minecraft is finally a physical reality. Some of the Mojang team flew out to LEGO World on Thursday to film a trailer and officially announce the product. Photographs and tweets flew out in all directions from Notch and Lydia in particular, showing the different designs. A LEGO Creeper features in the set as well as a Steve figure, bringing some Minecraft familiarity into the world of LEGO. This set is open for pre-orders now and is coming summer 2012. Links, as always, are below.
This week's snapshot, 12W07A, was quickly changed for 12W07B to fix some annoying bugs. But regardless of that, the snapshot brings some exciting changes, including the new world file system, which Jeb and John have named Anvil. Complicated bits aside, to us players it boils down to a promising future for modders and the game's compatibility with mods. Our vanilla saves will be converted when we open them to play, so read the Mojang blog information carefully if you're not backed up. Excitingly and visibly, it means that we gain the ability to build up to a height of 256 blocks by default, which is phenomenal considering the previous was 128 blocks. We foresee skyscrapers and megastructures being built all over the place.
Redstone lamps have been added and are created thusly, using 4 redstone and 1 glowstone block. They can be switched on and off using the normal methods of circuitry or pressure plates, levers, etc. They make great light sources for inside houses, adding some nice tactile on-off realism to the existing lighting options in Minecraft.
All of the animals have been changed over to the new AI system, as John stated that the old code was having to be maintained still. It makes more sense like this and of course pushes everything forward once more. Superb stuff. Zombies, skeletons and zombie pigmen have had their rare drops, features in last week's snapshot news, nerfed. So expect them to be even more infrequent now and consider yourself all the more lucky when you get one.
Some nights are more terrifying than others for villagers now, as zombies make a concerted effort to hunt down the poor village folk. However, villagers have now figured out how to repopulate their villages to keep the numbers at a sensible level. This of course results in delightful wee babby villagers that run around at high speeds, ducking in and out of houses and following or chasing each other around in quite extraordinarily adorable ways. Finally, if you want to add to a village, you now have an incentive to create a house or houses which villagers will actually inhabit, providing they're properly kitted out with a roof, walls and a door.
That's all for this week's, folks. The links and squinks bit below is bursting with clickables. You can also click here to catch up on last week's news, or click here for the next episode if you're a little bit late. Please click the subscribe button and we'll see you all next time.